Welcome to Startup Health TV. This is another COVID-19 special health innovation update. I'm Logan Plaster, and I'm with Tatyana Kanzaveli, CEO and founder of Open Health Network. Tatyana, thanks for joining me on the call.
Thank you for the invite. Glad to be here.
How are you doing?
Tough times, yeah. No doubts.
You're in Southern California, right?
I'm in Northern Silicon Valley.
Okay, yeah. Silicon Valley. So yeah. What's it like right now? It's Monday morning, your time.
I know. Lockdown has been for a while. Recently, they're closing parks as well. And it's not easy, I would say, from a business point of view, from personal point of view. Isolation, I think, has impact on, I would say, every single person I'm in touch with. So, Now it's extended till May. So, yeah.
We just found out. I'm in Baltimore, and we just got a stay home order from the governor. So, kind of recalibrating what that means, just in terms of getting out and about a little bit to stay sane.
Yeah, and I think it's important for all of us be aware that we need to stay healthy. You see what I mean? So, outside of COVID itself, we need to pay more attention for personal health and health of people close to us, because healthcare systems are overloaded with COVID. So it's our responsibility to adapt our lifestyle and make sure we can stay healthy.
Yeah. So we're doing these quick 5 to 7 minute updates with CEOs and founders of health innovation companies, and hearing what you're doing to kind of pivot or reframe what you're doing around the pandemic. Give us a quick 1 minute primer on Open Health Network and what you've built, and then we can talk about kind of how you're focusing that on the current problem.
So Open Health Network develops a framework that enables healthcare organizations to rapidly develop and deploy highly sophisticated digital health offerings, from apps to voice apps, chatbots, and so on. So it has been used by UCSF, Mount Sinai, UCLA. We're working with, you know, Cleveland Clinic, American Heart Association, many other big companies. And we're completely agnostic to the disease area or type of healthcare organization. So we've been doing a lot of great work in cancer, in cardiovascular diseases, autism, wellness, mental health.
So you do a little bit of everything. It sounds very high level. So maybe you can give me like a case study of how you might work in cancer, or how you might, or maybe we just use COVID-19 as a case study.
Right. So the rapid development platform enables you develop things rapidly. So I'll give you an example of COVID. So when we looked at what was happening with this horrible virus, we realized that, you know, we can rapidly develop and deploy something that people can use. And it took us literally, I'm telling you, from start to finish, 2 days to deploy.
2 days?
2 days, 2 days. Oh. To develop symptoms tracker right now. So you can start tracking your symptoms, such as cough, fever, not feeling well, all kind of different symptoms. You can do it from day one when you're not feeling well. Mm-hmm. You have a report that has, for example, your fever points 5 times a day for 5 days, or all, and report covers like every single symptom you captured, including medications. You can share that with your physician before you do telehealth, or before you go, you see what I mean? So it enables them to look at everything and make sense. So when they give you the right escalation channel, which is invaluable, but we also track things such as, have you been tested for COVID? Is it been confirmed? We also track if people who have been diagnosed and recovered from COVID positive to negative 2 weeks out, if they will be willing to donate plasma, and we match them with researchers who need that plasma for research to develop vaccine and treatment. We also give them location of COVID testing places close by, along with medication tracking.
When you say tracking, what do you mean exactly? So let's say I'm a COVID-19 patient, or I'm concerned that I am. And so I log on to Google, I start thinking about my symptoms. Is this something that I have to log in through my provider? You would be the go-between instead of going into my doctor?
So the way it works right now, you're not feeling well, and you're kind of, okay, let me take an aspirin or something, hot tea with honey. And yeah. You, 3 days after, you're like, oh, I think I'm feeling worse. And then you try to get in touch with the physician, and they're like, and they ask you all those questions. So did you have fever 4 days ago? What was it? Yeah. How does do this? So we basically take all that out so you can start tracking. And when you can send all your data in one report, we email the physician before you even, so they can see the trends across many different parameters, and they can give you the right advice without wasting time on asking all those questions. We also track your pre-existing conditions, and we can adapt to be used by healthcare, integrate with EHR, pick risk factors, and incorporate very specific suggestions. All of that can be white labeled as well.
Got it.
But
okay.
Imagine all of this that I told you. You can go to our website, it's out there, free resource, it's a web app, it's iOS, Android app, and all of that has been built within 2 days and deployed.
Wow. So, and that is sort of highlighting your rapid deployment platform.
Exactly.
Gotcha.
Yes.
It's a case study of what you're doing across all verticals. That's awesome.
We also have like front end, back end. We have gamification. We have escalation. We have workflows. We have role-based management. We have all kind of algorithms that can be deployed front end and back end. So the systems that we build, and one of the case studies for complex disease management that will actually press release going out tomorrow morning with Mount Sinai for Crohn's disease, IBS, IBD, will tell you more how this framework can be used for complex disease management in COVID times especially. Yeah.
Got it. Okay. So you were saying that it's on your website. Remind me what site that is. What's the domain?
It's openhealth.cc.
Openhealth.cc. So if I have symptoms, I can go there and start tracking my own symptoms.
Yeah.
And your system will hold that information and keep it in a way that can then be given to my doctor, even if my doctor isn't working with you directly, isn't contracted with you. How does that work?
Yeah. So within an app, there is an icon on the top right corner, share button. So you just click that share button, type an email of your physician, and goes to your physician.
Okay.
So very you nice. Don't need to even interact with us or anything. You just can email to whoever you want to email to, very detailed report. But the beautiful thing is that on the back end, now we have over 10,000 people using it, right?
Fantastic.
So we start publishing graphs that tell people on, it's aggregated, of course, content identified, but there are like 50% people who track their symptoms experience GI symptoms, right? So it's not just about fever and cough. So now we can help physicians and everybody else to understand correlation between different types of symptoms and in relation to COVID recovery, testing. Gotcha. And yeah, so it's very powerful.
I've seen some of your maps. It's very interesting. What other insights have you pulled from them besides anything else of note besides the GI complications?
Yeah, so we capture information at the zip code level. So the extremely powerful thing is that we can potentially predict the next hotspot before people have been tested and confirmed having COVID, because we have a bunch of people, and it's extremely high resolution at the zip code level, yeah. Right? So this testing is not available, so everyone is kind of doesn't know where to put more resources, send more ventilators. Yeah. But if this gets wide adopted, then we can help people. You can see on the map, a published map.
Sure.
You can see where potential hotspots could be and plan to have enough resources to help those people, even before they have been officially diagnosed with COVID.
So in an ideal world, people would be downloading the free app, and they would, as soon as they had symptoms, they would start tracking, and we'd start having this de-identified symptom tracking mapping that would start to reveal some hotspots. Remind me.
The map is on our website, so okay. People can go now. It's the map, we published it. We're doing it, you know, to help people. So we're not hiding anything. We're not holding. We're publishing stuff. The map is available. And if public health officials will, we can, you know, adapt to their needs. It can be white labeled. But if they will ask people to use it, we can help public health officials to allocate the resources to plan, because we can see things before they actually have been confirmed.
Got it. All through
at the zip code level.
Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah.
At the zip code level.
Self-reporting. If I want to find it on the App Store, I happen to have an iPhone here. What should I search for?
Patient Sphere for COVID.
Sorry.
Patient Sphere. For COVID.
Sphere for COVID.
But we have all the links available on our website.
Sphere for COVID. Got it.
Right.
Free
all
app.
All the links published on our website.
Yep.
www.openhealth.cc. And we also have web apps. So if people don't have smartphone, they can just go and use web app.
Okay.
Spanish version, the same in Spanish, is coming up today or tomorrow, the latest.
Mm-hmm.
And I hope, you know, people will know this resource is available that can be very helpful to them, but also for other people.
And you said 10,000 or so people have used it so far as you're collecting data? Okay.
Yep.
Awesome.
Within a few days, with no marketing, with no.
Are there plans to try to market it, or is this hoping that it kind of goes viral on its own? Not to use that term too often.
We are a startup, right? So, this is something that we've done to do good, but we don't just have funds to market. But
sure.
Yeah. So we just.
Who would be, you mentioned the government, who would be other sort of ideal partners that you'd like to have reach out to you about this? Who would you like to be working with as partners?
Providers, okay. And insurance companies. Because if providers tell their patients, this is not something that they can do in Epic, right? Please log your symptoms, send us report. It will help us to quickly help you to escalate. Otherwise, people just show up call, and that's extreme pressure on limited resources they have.
Sure.
We can white label. It could be your own app. We can add content. We can add features. It's literally a matter of seconds for us. We don't need to write code. We have content modules. We have workflow modules. We have all of that. We can drag and drop any specifics. And I think it's a resource that should be used to help, providers and everybody else.
Can be very helpful at the provider level, at the insurance company level, but even at a governmental level to try to get people on a single system to map symptoms. What I'm hearing is that it's two big goals here. You're releasing some pressure from the system because you are monitoring people's symptoms from home, but then you're also doing this key mapping function, de-identified, so that you can anticipate hotspots before they happen.
Yep.
Is that right?
That's a great summary.
What is the best way for people to get in touch with you if they want to learn more?
contact@openhealth.cc.
Okay, contact@openhealth.cc. Awesome. Well, I love the work that you're doing. I'm going to be following the maps that you've been putting out closely and seeing what develops. Hopefully things flatten out and we have good news coming in the coming weeks. But in the meantime, really appreciate you pushing on this and offering so much for free in the meantime and offering so many of your services to the industry. So Tatyana, appreciate
Thank you.
All of that.
Thank you. Thank you for your support.
All right. Take care.
Take care. Bye.
Bye.